والله يدعو إلى دار السلام ويهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم.
Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. And for the book you revealed therein to guide us to the light.
Inna alhamdulillah. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the longest oath in the Quran, والشمس وضحاها والقمر إذا تلاها والنهار إذا جلاها والليل إذا يغشاها والسماء وما بناها والأرض وما طحاها ونفس وما سواها فألهمها فجورها وتقواها قد أفلح من زكاها وقد خاب من دساها. الله سبحانه وتعالى in Surah Al-Shams swore by different elements of his creation, by the sun, by the moon, by the earth, by the heaven, and at the end, and by the soul and the one who fashioned it. And he made it inclined to goodness and inclined to wickedness. And here it is, successful indeed, the one who purifies his nafs, and a loser indeed, the one who fails to do so. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the hadith fi sahih al-Bukhari wa Muslim min hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu an, he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إذا جاء رمضان, when Ramadan is here, فتحت أبواب الجنة, the gates of Jannah will be open, وغلقت أبواب النيران, the gates of the hellfire will be shut. Here it is. وَصُفِّدَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَسُلْسِلَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ فِي رِوَايَةٍ, and the shayateen will be chained. Every time we do something wrong, we say, shaitan, shaitan, shaitan. And we forget about an enemy that resides inside ourselves. That enemy is our nafs. Yes, brothers and sisters in Islam, you have an enemy inside you, eats with you, drinks with you, sleeps with you, is your nafs, your own nafs. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي. Indeed, the nafs is inclined to evil, except the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the best person who ever achieved servitude, ubudiyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in all his speeches, at the beginning, he would say, وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِن شُرُورِ أَنفُسِنَا, and I seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of my nafs. From the evil of my nafs. And this is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What about you and me? Brothers and sisters in Islam, fi sunan al-Tirmidhi, When Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about words that he can say in the morning and words that he can say at night, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him certain words, and in these words, وَأَعُوذُ بِكَ مِن شَرِّ نَفْسِي, and I seek refuge with you, O Allah, from the evil of my nafs. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a lot of Muslims are unaware of that enemy, and they blame shaitan all the time. Now in Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chained Ramadan for you, has chained Satan for you in Ramadan. Now the impact of Satan at least is lessened. Now your nafs should be exposed to you. You should know what is wrong with your nafs now. Brothers and sisters in Islam, have you ever heard somebody saying, I have been trying to give up this sin, but I cannot? You know why? Because he cannot tell his nafs no. Have you ever heard this person saying, I promised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to repent from this sin, and I did for a week, and then I went back to it. You know why? Because of his nafs. Don't you see sometimes some people in the masjid, and by all of a sudden they disappear? And then they come back maybe later on, in a year or so, and then they re-disappear again. It's because of their nafs. Don't you hear some people saying, I cannot give up that sin, I can't, because of their nafs. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the first arena of jihad is your nafs. You must wage war against your nafs in order to make it. In nafs, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said, is a mountain in your way to Allah. Imagine you traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is only one way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the way, there is a huge mountain. That mountain is your nafs. If you want to continue traveling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you must climb that mountain. You must climb that mountain in order to make it. If you don't, you will not make it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You must, brothers and sisters in Islam, do jihad against your nafs. There is a statement that some people attribute to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, which is not true, but the meaning of the statement is rooted in the guidance. They say that after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam returned from the battle of Tabuk, he told his companions, عُدْنَا مِنَ الْجِهَادِ الْأَصْغَرِ إِلَى الْجِهَادِ الْأَكْبَرِ. We returned from the minor jihad to the major jihad. The companions asked him, what is the major jihad, O Messenger of Allah? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the jihad that we wage against ourselves. Number one, the scholars of hadith say that this hadith is fabricated. The chain of narration is no good. But the meaning of the hadith is rooted in the guidance. Yes, in order for you to be able to go to the battlefield and offer yourself in the cause of Allah, you must be able to say your nafs no in the regular life. Billahi alik, somebody who does not wake up for Fajr, you know, very early in the morning Fajr, the bed is so nice and good and sweet, and his nafs tells him, no, sleep, 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 I want you to sleep. You cannot tell no to your nafs. You're going to go and give your nafs up in the battlefield? Yes, you must wage war against your nafs first in order to have the guts and the power and the strength to be out there in the battlefield. Brothers and sisters in Islam, how can you climb that mountain, the mountain of the nafs? You must do something called tazkiyah. You must purify your nafs. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. By the soul, and the one who perfected it. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. The nafs is inclined to evil and inclined to goodness. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Successful indeed the one who will purify it. They tell you this. If you do not purify your nafs will ride you to the hellfire. If you do not convince your nafs of the agenda, and the agenda here is the guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought down for you in order to purify that nafs with, rest assured that your nafs will take you to the hellfire. Brothers and sisters in Islam, rest assured that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can purify you, and you purify your nafs before you start. Rest assured that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can help you purify your nafs. You know the dua Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya hayyu ya qayyum, bi rahmatika astaghith, aslih li sha'ni kullah, wala takilni ila nafsi tarfata ayn, wala aqalla min dhalik. O Allah, do not allow my nafs to be in control of me for a blink of an eye. Not even less than this. Not even less than this. The scholars of the predecessors, they say that a person who sins, you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did to him? He allowed his nafs to be in control of him. You see, what you want? You want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come between you and your nafs. You remember, you're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're seeking refuge, help with Allah against your nafs. You're saying, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min sharri nafsi. Oh Allah, I seek refuge with you from the evil of my nafs. So only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, brothers and sisters, can help you purify that nafs. The second thing that you need to understand, so, and it's very important, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of the nafs. يسألونك عن الروح ويسألونك عن الروح قل الروح من أمر ربي وما أوتيتم من العلم إلا قليلا. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the maker of that nafs. He knows how this nafs should be purified. Why I'm saying this? Because you'll find some people making their own ijtihadat. Like the Christians, they go and sit in the monastery and they think that this is a way to purify their nafs. Or other people, they will say that, okay, I'm not going to drink for or eat for a year or 2 years. No. The manhaj, the guidance that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam delivered to you and he implemented in front of you was meant to help you against your nafs. Now, Allah is the maker of the nafs. He delivered the guidance with which you should use to purify that nafs. Now, do not abandon this guidance and invent your own guidance. It does not make any sense. Billahi alayk, if you buy a car, a certain maker, I don't want to say names, but they give you a manual of how to work this car. Now, if the car breaks, do you go to the other maker or do you go to the same maker of the car? You go to the same maker to help you fix the car because there is a problem with the car. The same thing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the maker, is the creator of your nafs. He knows how to purify your nafs. Then seek the guidance. Now, how can you purify your nafs? This is a golden question that we must answer, inshallah. And inshallah, brothers and sisters in Islam, the next episode, we're going to answer this question. Do not miss the next episode. Inshallah, we're going to talk about how to purify your nafs, how you lead your nafs to goodness and stop your nafs from leading you to the hell fire. How can you become amongst the successful who are the successful, the people who purify their nafs? Ramadan is your second chance to get a handle of your nafs and to purify your nafs. Do not waste this opportunity. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. Each deed of the seed of Adam is for him except for one. Oh Lord of this blessed month, we praise you for Ramadan. And for the book you revealed therein to guide us to the light. By your grace you sent us this Qur'an each day that we recite. And for the book you revealed therein to guide us to the light.